I'm nothing like you guys. I'm fucking a person of God, of Christ, of something you will never comprehend.
At last there is breath when the monster weeps, pain so unbearable that feels insanely good. When it's broken and aching, it gnaws at the wounds. Nothing ever hurt it. It lives to destroy itself, ripping its heart out and putting it back, laying and suffering in the puddles of blood. The monster is in fact immune to the act. No tears in his eyes, just a soul dipped in black.
Ladies and gentlemen, meet your new homecoming queen, Sharon Cookie Wiggins.
Rawr, it's so fucking hot.
The best part about being super queer is you get to know these women for these sad, beautiful, broken creatures that they are. And you get to let them shine in a way that maybe you wouldn't if you were, say, a heterosexual. I think if you're broken, you're also a hero. You go through so much and deal with so much shit that nobody will ever understand, but you shine anyways. The world was shocked to find our best friend, our father of America, Bob Saget, was dead. So I had to celebrate with Shara. We had to have our own weird, fucked up homecoming dance that we never got to have. Cheers. Now let's celebrate Black History Month with the whitest girl I know, Shara. When I make love to somebody, I disassociate. Disassociation issues. Shara's teaching me to actually make eye contact since we're always, you know, like on social media and working with computers and, you know, basically staring at like things that don't have a soul. It's nice to look at somebody with a soul. Less than 24 hours ago, I found out that one of my best friends was dead. I heard certain details, but leave it to a girl named Melita to tell me what happened, even if she wasn't there and even if she didn't care. She was going to tell you what really happened. Cheers. We always say Black Lives Matter, but what about the yellow bones? They matter too.
See, I've been working in the mortuary business for about going on 75 years now, and I love the dead so much. I prefer them. I prefer them over the living. Oh, we get some real special, some so special that I don't even want to give them, you know, a proper burial because they're just so beautiful, you know. People think we're odd folks, but we're just like everybody else. We love the dead. We love them to death, you know.
Thank you.
Goodbye, my friend. Na 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 na. If not the end, na 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 na. So glad you made it. Time will never, never, never.
Daddy, do you love me?
Daddy, love me. Daddy, love me. I am incapable of love, but I do find you enduring only for the fact that you are a mimic knockoff version of me, only to fulfill my narcissistic values of passing on my legacy.
Oh gosh, Daddy.
Ніхто не знає, як ще вміння Йова. І телевізор з потолка свисає. І як його мені ніхто не знає.
Wake up!
Even in heaven I'm still popular and beautiful, and forget any memories of me where tequila is part of the story, turn all the love I made you feel on earth into something good.
Come and be my baby tonight. Come and be my baby tonight. I see the way you treated all the mother thugs you've been with. Come and be my baby tonight.
You know you are all fake as hell, but I love you anyway.
Oh,
Want to talk to the hottest homeless guys around? Call 1-900 Horny and Homeless. These boys are so poor they'll do anything for a warm meal. Are you a single mother raising children and need to take out your hate? Order one of these homeless boys now. They'll be your little slave and they'll take out the trash. These boys gave up on themselves a long time ago. So horny, dumb, young, and all they could do is make you come. Horny homeless men, 1-900 Horny Homeless Men. Call now. They're waiting for you and they only have a couple minutes on their phone. Hurry.
Fucking those other guys and sucking their small fucking penises.